I have a theory for media in this book, that is, media is a product of imperialism. When the explorer started from Europe, a reporter came behind him. The job of the reporter was, the explorer came, like Vasco da Gama, Columbus, Sir H.M. Stanley, etc., and many of them. They were representing joint stock companies. Dutch East India Company, Portuguese Company, East India Company. And the owners of those companies were their governments and their rich people. Those people wanted veracity of data. Mera paisa laga na kisi company ke andar. I would like to know, not from the manager, but a third party, or you know, big five kind of thing. So reporter became big five. So reporter's DNA is to report negative. The product, media is a product of imperialism, when I say. So either bad hai hai, you know, fight ho raha hai. So no good news is no news has come from that mindset. India has to write, Indian media has to write that good news can also be a news. Social media is showing it. The kind of videos that are played much more are good looking. I mean, you, main kai baar dekhta hu, itna acha article likh leta hu, to us par like nahi aate hain. Aap kutte ko biscuit khilate hue picture dal do, to bahut like aate hain. Kyun aate hain? Human emotions. We have got it wrong as journalists. We have got it wrong because our DNA is wrong. I don't know what APJ Abdul Kalam has said, but I think we need to reset this entire media narrative. Is this, with the advent of social media, it is already being done. That's why the mainline media is becoming more and more irrelevant. The numbers are not increasing. Because as a human being, अरे हमारे यहाँ तो ऐसा बोलते हैं ना कि आप लगातार दुख में नहीं रह सकते, लगातार नेगेटिव नहीं रह सकते. If you read Bharat Muni's Natya Shastra, if there are bhava, there are positive bhava and negative bhava, no? I can never be always in negative bhava or rasa. So I think media will reset itself as per our society, our value system, our sanskaras. It is already beginning to happen, sir.